within the body. We think the mind is inside the body. Actually, body is inside the mind. Okay. So sun, moon, stars, everything is in Manamaya Kosha. It's huge. Why can't you feel it? Like you can feel the body, no? Why can't you feel the sun? It is available in Manomaya Kosha. Body is available for senses. Okay. This sun and moon is available for this sense only, eyes only. It's still in the Manomaya Kosha, bigger. I had a problem of 60 kg body weight only, very worried. Annamaya Kosha. Now imagine your body is the whole world. All these, you don't have weight problem. Okay, but there's a problem of head weight actually. Mind, Manamaya Kosha causes a lot of head weight. Lot of problems and worries in your head. But actually Manamaya Kosha is occupying the entire world. The whole universe is occupied by Manamaya Kosha. So now your Manamaya Kosha is overlapping. Okay. There is some specific to the you, but general to all of us. Sun and moon is general to all of us. But your worries and problems are specific to you, closer to you. But otherwise, Manomaya Kosha is big.
Annamaya Kosha is inside
Manomaya Kosha. Annamaya Kosha is inside Pranamaya Kosha. Pranamaya Kosha is inside the Manomaya Kosha. Pranamaya Kosha is only goes to up to 12 inches. Pranamaya Kosha up to this layer. Your aura.
12 inches outside the body.
Outside the body.
Physical body.
Right? Manomaya Kosha is
entire universe.
So,
all the Annamaya Koshas are inside Manomaya Kosha. All the Annamaya Kosha. Who's Manomaya Kosha?
Yours. Are you not able to see me?
Okay, your Annamaya Kosha is inside my Manomaya Kosha.
We are all like, your Annamaya Kosha is in my Manomaya Kosha. My Annamaya Kosha is in your Manomaya Kosha.
It's like mirrors, multiple mirrors.
You see, mirrors, no? We are like mirrors, right? One face is in other face, it's like a universe is like, actually the Buddha says this very beautifully. He gives an example of universe as, imagine the universe as a large number of diamonds, infinite diamonds, okay? Each diamond is shining and the shining is reflecting the other diamond. Like that, it is entire universe. Actually, you are seeing me and I am seeing you. You are in my Manomaya Kosha and I am in your Manomaya Kosha. Okay. So, Manomaya Kosha is bigger. Vidyanamaya Kosha is much more subtler than this. Much bigger. All of them uses the body, finally.
And Guruji, what comes in Vidyanamaya Kosha?
Buddhi, intellect, decision making. Okay, discrimination.
So Manomaya Kosha is inside Vijnanamaya Kosha. Must be beyond Manomaya Kosha.
Which one?
Intellect. So you are saying intellect is beyond the universe.
No, intellect is beyond not universe. Intellect is beyond Manomaya Kosha.
That's what you said. Manomaya Kosha is universe. The whole universe.
All universe is happening in Manomaya Kosha. But universe has all the living beings are controlled by Buddhi, no? Intellect, no?
Yes. So Buddhi should be inside the universe.
How can you? Controlling is always higher, no? Okay, that's why in Buddhi, I'll repeat. Ishwaraha.
Sarva Bhutanam.
Adi Arjuna.
Tishtati.
Okay. God is in a Vidyanamaya Kosha. The Vidyanamaya Kosha is called heart.
It's controlling Manomaya.
It is controlling the Vidyanamaya Kosha controls Manomaya.
Yeah, yeah.
Subtle.
Yeah, subtle.
Okay. See, now all Vidyanamaya Koshas are overlapping. Finally, Chidabhasa. Or Brahman reflects in this Vidyanamaya Kosha. Ishwara. Okay. God is in your heart means he is in the Vidyanamaya Kosha. Not only in your Vidyanamaya Kosha, all Vidyanamaya Koshas also. ईश्वरः
ईश्वरः
सर्वभूतानां
सर्वभूतानां
प्रद्येशे
अर्जुन
अर्जुन
तिष्ठति
तिष्ठति
भ्रामयन्
सर्वभूतानि
सर्वभूतानि
यन्त्रारूढानि
यन्त्रारूढानि
मायया
मायया
ईश्वरः सर्वभूतानां हृदि अर्जुन तिष्ठति इन द हार्ट ऑफ ऑल लिविंग बीइंग्स गॉड इज द ईश्वर ओके बट वी आर ट्राइंग टू फाइंड गॉड इन द टेंपल ओके टू फाइंड द गॉड यू हैव टू गो इनसाइड बट यू आर गोइंग आउटसाइड okay when there is a heart it is not a physical heart it is the buddhi now where is the buddhi buddhi is all pervading see all pervading means a part of the buddhi works for us and part of the buddhi is universal right so we are all part of the universe vidnanamaya kosha then deeper than that is anandamaya kosha it's called ananda bliss okay anandamaya kosha is when you go to deep sleep you are in the anandamaya kosha ananda now what is the size of your body it is unlimited infinite okay now up to vidnanamaya kosha you can say there is a limit anandamaya kosha there is no limit you are become unlimited infinite So that is called Anandamaya Kosha.
Nothing exists in Anandamaya.
Bliss, sir. Nothing.
No, I mean, all these other koshas are not.
All the koshas are there in Anandamaya Kosha. They are all subtle, in the subtle form, sukshma rupa. So Anandamaya Kosha is when you sleep. Okay. That's why it's called Anandamaya Kosha. You feel limitless and rested in deep sleep. Okay. And where is Atma, the real you? I told you there are two yous, right? Mm-hmm. What is that? What you? One is what you think you are, what others think of you, and what you really are. So whatever you really you are, divine. Is beyond Anandamaya Kosha. All koshas exist in that. Our whole world view is ulta pulta. We think we are a small body. Mind is inside us. Atma is inside us. In reality, everything is there, subtler and less, sukshma, sukshma, sukshma. That's why we are not able to see it. Okay. What is beyond Anandamaya Kosha is called Atma or Brahman. Brahman and God and Atma means same thing. Okay. Now to see God, you have to make your mind subtler and go inside, not outside. If at all you want to see God. If you want to see your husband or wife or a girl or a boy, you go outside. If you want to go to Atma, you have to make your mind subtle and go inside. Okay. So Atma is beyond all this koshas.
How do you make your mind subtle?
This whole class is that now. I have to start from a big thing and go small. If I suddenly start going to small, then you will, next class attendance will not be there. Guru is telling something I can't understand. So that's why you have to start from A, B, C, D, E, F, Z. Right? It takes quite some time to make the mind subtle. Okay? This is only a process. Right? So gradually mind becomes subtle. Suddenly, your mind is like, you know, a pumpkin. Now the pumpkin has to be made into sesame seed. It has to be made into sesame seed. That is what is called meditation.
What do you say? So, one you say see inside, but then you say that Atma Brahman.
No, that's inside because from your point of view. Mm-hmm. See, from your point of view, first class it's asked for. Show me where you are. Is it here? Mm-hmm. So, from your point of view, it's here. But it's here is not just here. It is everywhere. You start and say, whenever you say, speak to me, I'm here. No. He'll say, I'm here is for you here because your mind is so gross.
But we should be able to see anywhere.
Huh?
We should be able to see anywhere.
Experience that.
Not anywhere. We should be able to make your mind subtle to go deeper. See, here the purpose is not to make you Superman. Okay, to be able to read, at least read what is happening in the mind of wife. Not like that. So here the mind is not, the idea is to give you some siddhis or supernatural powers. Okay, there are different classes. Here only purpose is to find out your Atma, God. And for that, how to make your mind? Sukshma, sukshma, subtle. Right? Okay. Suddenly I can't make, so I'm meeting gradually. Why I can't make, I'll tell you. Because you are already stuck with a lot of things. Right? So why it's inside? Because it's for you, it's inside. You tell me, where is mind? Here only. Now you don't know outside, inside. Did you understand? Right? So Anandamaya Kosha is deep inside. That's what you go to sleep. Now I'll tell you. Give me a situation where you are very happy in life, Rajini. Don't know. So what makes you happy? Nobody answers. The mind has become so sukshma. What makes you happy?
Yeah. The mind is silent.
No. What makes you happy?
All others are like materials, just for some time.
No. See, we think something makes me happy. Mm-hmm. But people don't know the real secret of happiness. Mm-hmm. For example, give me the banana. Or orange. Okay. So people say, I'm just giving orange. It can be for some people it's orange, some people it will be jamun, some people it will be jalebi, some people it will be peg of whiskey, some people it will be a lot of money. Okay, it can be many things. So it makes me happy, they say. Right? Really, what happens is that let's say I take it as a jamun or sweet. I put it in the mouth. The moment I put it in the mouth, Annamaya Kosha, it goes. Mm-hmm. Annamaya Kosha becomes silent. Pranamaya Kosha becomes silent. Manomaya Kosha becomes silent. Vidnamaya Kosha becomes silent. Deeper inside, silent. Suddenly, Ananda comes from Anandamaya Kosha. So the happiness came from Anandamaya Kosha. Okay? Happiness didn't come from the eating. Happiness because all these koshas got switched off. Moment to moment. Then you go to deepest kosha, Anandamaya Kosha. Anandamaya Kosha also did not get happiness. Anandamaya Kosha got happiness from Atma. Okay? So, the happiness came from Atma. And one drop came and that you said so happy. Okay? You didn't know the happiness came from deep inside, Atma. You thought that happiness came from? Orange, whiskey, brandy or movie. Right? So now this is a total confusion. Because of that you are addicted to the external thing.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Really, the happiness is coming from Atma. Okay. So, and once you get what is it, mind becomes silent. Annamaya Kosha, Pranamaya Kosha, Manomaya Kosha, Vidyanamaya Kosha becomes silent momentarily. One small switch off. And that small switch off, the bliss comes from Atma all the way to this point. And that you say so much happiness. Okay? According to Upanishads, that happiness is not even one drop of happiness of Atma. One drop. Then you should understand how much happiness Atma is. Okay? So you tell maximum happiness. She told last time maximum, and her daughter got married. Okay? So much happiness. Imagine that is one drop of happiness of Atma. The happiness of Atma should be how much? And that is your happiness really. But what you are trying to do is get small, little drops of happiness from outside. Understand? So, the question is, how do you tap the happiness from Atma all the time? Is the meditation, really. Okay, that's the meaning of meditation. And one who is able to tap, one who is able to have that happiness all the time is called Jivanmukta or liberated. Mukti means that much only. Mukti means not going some ticket, taking a ticket and going somewhere. Okay, mukti means happiness of atma experienced all the time. Did I tell the scale of happiness of atma in Upanishad? Anybody? Did the last class?
No.
In this class, I didn't tell. Okay, so there's a measurement scale. Our rishis told. Did you hear that last time? There's a measurement scale for happiness. Okay, imagine. Imagine somebody is very, very rich in the universe, billionaire. He has a beautiful family. Okay, he has children. He has all the power to take control of anything in the world. Okay, and imagine his happiness is one unit. Imagine his happiness is one unit. Perfect happiness. Okay, now if happiness is one unit, what's your happiness actually? Please give me a comparison. Imagine a person who is very powerful, everything in the world, all wealth, okay, no problem, no disease. His happiness is one unit. Then you tell me what's your happiness?
Small fraction. Very small fraction.
What is that? 0.1, 0.01?
Yeah, 0.00001.
Okay. So now, there are higher level lokas called Gandharva loka. Oh, sorry, there is Swarga loka, heaven. That is people want to go to Swarga loka, right? After death. Okay, some enjoyment is there, especially beautiful dances, apsaras, and a lot of alcohol which you don't get in the earth, special brand. And whatever you want, you'll get it. So the happiness in Swarga loka, okay, 100 units of happiness of a man in the world, 100 units of happiness of what I said, a rich man, is one unit of happiness in Swarga loka. Okay, now you have a lot of motivation to go to Swarga loka. Now you know how people, why people kill themselves, put bombs themselves and blow up because Swarga, they want to go to Swarga.
They can do whatever they want.
That is only 100 units of happiness of one man here is one unit of happiness in Swarga loka. Okay, now 100 units of happiness, okay, that one unit of happiness in Swarga loka. Then there's something Gandharva loka. Gandharva loka is slightly higher than Swarga loka, where there are all musicians. They enjoy the music all the time. They are called the devatas, music devatas. Actually, those music devatas operate through musicians in the world. See, the sangeetkaras are the musicians are there, no? They, you see, you have to see their face. What music? Okay. When they say, there's so much of bliss is there, right? So for the bliss to come, the Gandharva devatas have to operate. Okay. So how much bliss they should have? So 100 units of happiness of Swarga loka is one unit of happiness in the Gandharva loka. You got what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Now, Gandharva loka itself is happy. They are always the musicians. So Gandharva loka happiness you take is one unit. Then there is a karma devata loka. Karma devata loka means higher than the Gandharva loka. So these karma devatas are, if you do a lot of good punya on the earth, not little bit, one certain puja, this puja, no. A lot of big pujas, especially yadnas. Soma Yaja Yadna, Ashwamedha, these are big yadnas, huge number of.
How many yadnas are there?
Lot. There are big yadnas are Ashwamedha, Soma Yaja, okay, the yadna. And what I am doing is the highest yadna, it's called Brahma Yadna. Okay, the teaching of Atmanthana is called Brahma Yadna, that's the highest. Teaching of Bhagavad Gita is called Brahma Yadna, that's the greatest. So even if you do one yadna, you'll get a lot of punya and you can enjoy so much of happiness. Okay, so if you do big yatnas like Soma Yaji or Ashwamedha, then you can get to become the ruler of the Swarga. People in Swarga itself, they enjoy. So the boss of Swarga, like Indra and all those things, they are called Karma Devatas. So they can enjoy a lot more. So 100 units of happiness of Gandharva Devatas is one unit of happiness of Karma Devatas. Okay, now Karma Devatas themselves are very happy. Then there are some devatas higher than Karma Devatas. They are actually born as Ajanaja Devatas. Ajanaja. Ajanaja Devatas means they are not born in the, these Karma Devatas are born in earth. They did a lot of good punya and they get a promotion to Karma Devata. they have to do a lot of good punya in the earth, like Dharmaraja and all those good punya to get that. Now, beyond that, Ajanati Devatas, these Devatas are not going from here to there. They are born in Devalokas itself.
How?
So, those Devatas, they have got a visa already by birth. These Devatas have gone there. They have children, no? They are born in Devaloka only. They have not come from here.
Where were they born in Devaloka?
Huh?
Where were they born in Devaloka? There's no hospital
in there. There are also facilities there. Okay. So now they are called Ajanaja Devatas. Ajanaja Devatas means they are not human beings who have gone there. It's like equivalent of, you can think this America. In India, a lot of people go to America, right? A lot of struggle, they do a job and then get a visa, then green card, then citizenship, they get. And they have a child. The child gets a citizen, American green card, American visa, American citizenship by birth. Like that, Ajana Devatas, they get by birth Devatas. So, 100 units of happiness of Karmaja Devatas is equal to 1 unit of happiness of Ajanaja Devatas. They are like a born in rich man's family. They don't have to struggle anything now. Okay, so like that goes of course. Then 100 units of Ajanaja Devata happiness is equal to 1 unit of happiness in the Vaikuntha Loka. Brahma Loka or Vaikuntha Loka? It's called Satya Loka.
Both are same. Both are same.
Yeah, they're called different names. Okay, 1 unit of happiness is Satya Loka. Okay, so now beyond Satya Loka, you cannot compare. There's no scale. Up to that, it's maximum. Right. So, what happiness is there in Satya Loka? A human being also can experience some of this. A human being. A human being who is well versed in scriptures, well versed in Vedas, Upanishads, chanting and understanding, he can experience the happiness of these Devatas, Gandharva Devatas. Okay, then a Jnani, Jivan Mukta, like Ramana Maharshi and all. Okay, their happiness, there's no measurement at all, it's infinite. What happiness is there, Vaikuntha Loka, is not even a drop of happiness of the Jnani. What is it?
What life are we living?
Okay. That is what happiness experienced in Vaikuntha Loka is not, after that you cannot measure. Okay. That is not even a drop of happiness of the Atmadhyani. Why? The reason is that in everywhere in the all these lokas, you have to do some work to get the happiness. It's not free. You understand? Okay. Gandharva Loka, they have to sing music to become happy. Okay. Vaikuntha Loka, they have to do work actually. They have to do service to Vishnu and all those things. So daily operations are there, but they'll be happy. But Atmadhyani is happy by himself. He has become Atma himself, where there's no limit at all. So this Atma Darshana class means, okay. Atma Darshana class means I can't take you there, I can show you the directions. Then next tomorrow you'll come and say, I came to your 4 classes and you had it. So this class is, I will tell you, all rishis have told how to go to that level. Okay, now up to that, you after the, you going is your responsibility. I can only show you the direction.
Then your guru Ramana Maharshi has taught you how to see God in yourself.
Correct. I reached it. So I have to go, no? Ultimately, I can give you food. You have to eat the food, no? I can teach you, but ultimately you have to find, no? I can make you eat, no?
Yeah.
Right? So, is that clear? So Atmajnani's happiness is unlimited, infinite, because it's not, conditions are not there. Even Vaikuntha Loka, there's a condition. Okay, so you have heard of the Jaya Vijaya story?
Yes.
Okay, Jaya Vijaya, the rishis came and Jaya Vijaya didn't show respect. Then they were made thrown into Asura. So even Vaikuntha Loka also, there's a fear. He can be thrown to lower level lokas. Whereas Atmajnani Brahmajnani, there's no fear at all. He's bliss itself. Okay, so that is the Brahmajnana.
No one can throw
them out.
That's
why all devatas, including Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara, they bow down to a Brahmajnana, a human being who has reached that. Okay. Okay. So, is this clear now? Annamaya Kosha. just check up. Let us check up. Those who are on the online, are you able to hear what I said?
They have gone to Vaikuntha Loka.
So, did you hear? Sri Charan?
Yes, Prabhuji, I heard. Yes, Guruji.
Yeah, yes, Prabhuji.
Okay. Geeta? Subbu?
Yes, sir.
Recording.
Are they mute?
No, they're talking.
Geeta, are you able to hear?
Yes, sir.
Ask one of them to speak.
Can you speak, Geeta?
Hello.
Not able to hear you.
Hello. Sir, I'm hearing your voice, sir. Hello. Hello, sir.
Can you hear Geeta, can you talk?
Can I click on the speaker?
Prabhuji, we are able to hear.
I'm able to hear.
Yes, sir, I am also.
Now we are able to hear. Okay, so far we are not able to hear you.
Okay, sir.
Okay, any question? So, Subbu Pilupla, any?
Yes, Guruji, we are able to hear.
So, you understood how much happiness, you understand very well this visa business and getting children in America, right?
Yes.
Okay. So, any questions? Anybody else is there? Mr. Rao, any questions?
Rao is not there.
Okay. Then who else?
Robin.
Robin, any questions?
Hi, Prabhuji. No questions, Prabhuji. Currently.
Satyalata?
Yeah, Prabhuji, it is clear.
Okay.
But this particular picture, when we look at the picture, it looks like the Annamaya Kosha, I mean, inside the Annamaya Kosha, all the other koshas are appearing.
Right.
But as per what you're saying, outside Annamaya Kosha, we see every other kosha.
No, it's not actually outside. It is subtler and subtler. From your point of view, it's deeper and deeper.
Okay.
Deeper and deeper not mean, doesn't mean smaller and smaller. Deeper and deeper means bigger and bigger.
Okay.
I think the next slide is opposite, right?
Okay, let me show the next slide. No, yes, next slide.
There's one more, no, Guruji.
Last time you
showed.
Yeah, this is
So here you can see Annamaya Kosha is the smallest inside, and Vijnanamaya Kosha and Anandamaya Kosha and Atma everywhere.
Yeah.
This is the reality.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Okay.
Yeah.
So shall we proceed further?
Yeah, Prabhuji.
Okay. So now, why did I show this kosha? Actually, as we go deeper, all of us are connected. The manomaya koshas, everything is overlaps. At atma, everything is one. At the outer level, we appear separate. As we go deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper, the connections will be there. We can't see it. Okay. At the highest level, they're all one reality. And that's called God, Atma. Just deep inside. Okay. So why? What is the challenge of spirituality? We don't understand this. Okay. We don't understand this subtle. We think the mind is inside. Okay. Prana is inside. So we live in a with a wrong understanding of life. And we always look for happiness outside without knowing that happiness is coming from inside. Right? Okay. So what will happen if you do that like that, live like that? Happiness is from outside, not from inside. What will happen to your life?
Suffering.
Addiction. Addiction. Right? You're addicted to what? Somebody says, I'm addicted to liquor, whiskey. Actually, he's not addicted to whiskey. He's addicted to happiness from whiskey. People get addicted to objects outside. Really, they want happiness. But get dependent on objects. Now, when you become dependent on objects, what will happen to your life?
If you don't get it,
happiness you are getting from inside, free. Okay, but outside you have to pay for it.
Yes.
All right, you pay for it, but God happens from inside without knowing that, and again you go and pay for it. So ultimately you have to, you are addicted.
Pay for happiness.
Okay, become addicted to that. Now, what is the problem with addiction? Addiction is you become a slave of that. You become a slave of that.
So this, the
you means you think what you, right now you are thinking you are a body, no?
So mind.
No. Right now you think that you are a mind or a body, whatever is that. Right? You don't know the deeper level. Even mind also you are thinking a small piece in your head. So whatever you think you are, right? Already I told you, started with that. There is what you think you are, what world thinks of you, and what you really are. What you really are, you don't know. That's why you have come to this class. Okay? I know. That's why I'm. So this will create vasanas. This is called vasana. Vasana means impressions. Okay, so impressions, you can think actually somebody wants to drink it. I am just giving a coffee. I drink a cup of coffee. I am happy one day. Okay, next day I want a cup of coffee because I will be happy. Next day I want to begin a cup of coffee. I will be happy. Third day, if I don't drink a cup of coffee, I will be unhappy. Now you have become slave of coffee. Got it? This is called vasana. Okay. So now this vasanas will become, now I give an example of coffee as vasana. Now you just tell me, count how many vasanas you have. Okay. So we become slave of the external objects. Okay. Now our happiness is dictated by the external external objects. You pay for it, but happiness is from inside you. What is free, you are paying, and then you are suffering also. Right? It is like going and selling ice to Eskimos. They are living in Iceland. Okay? So So well, good marketer goes and says, oh, ice, this ice is very, very good ice brought from America. Okay, and you pay for it. Their ice is lying there only. And you become addicted and start suffering.
What Eskimo?
Eskimo is those people who live in the Antarctica. They have very snow. So they live in their snow houses only. So the marketing guy goes, and I am brought a beautiful ice from America. Pay for it. They can just go there and pick up the ice. Like that, you are like Eskimos. You are living in happiness and paying for happiness every day.
Limited happiness.
No. Limited happiness, unlimited payment. Unlimited payment.
Payment is unlimited.
See, every happiness you buy, you have to pay, no? Okay. For a cup of coffee, how much you have to pay?
10 rupees.
Starbucks is 200 rupees. Right? So let us say you earn 1 lakh rupees per month. Okay? Right? And you want a beautiful car, BMW car, which costs only 40 lakhs. Okay? So, 80 lakhs.
Which model?
Okay, 80 lakhs. So I want a BMW car to be happy. So how much I have to pay? I don't have money. And only a monthly per month I am getting 1 lakh. Okay, how many months you have to work for getting a BMW car?
More than 8 years.
To be happy?
More than
8 years.
7 years you have to work. Right? But happiness didn't come from the BMW car. Happiness came from pay of cost. You understand?
Comes in close BMW.
Okay, close. Right? That's for happiness from the BMW car. Now, I'll be happy if I get married. How many years you have to pay? All your money are paying for it. Okay, I'll be very happy if I have one child. Okay? How many years? One child today. It costs you for this morning up to the college, it becomes 2 crores. So your salary is 1 lakh per month. You are paying happiness of the child. Okay, two child is
double.
Right? So like that, we are paying very, very heavily for happiness which is freely available. That's all the point.
What? Management medical seat is 1 crore.
Right. So, the whole of spirituality is, okay, you think it's about God. Spirituality teaching is, you can be happy without any payment. That's all spirituality. Okay? And you don't have to...
Spirituality is not a profit.
Oh, not for profit. That happiness is called God. Okay, we have a lot of imagination about God. God means Anandamaya. Happiness is God. Okay, God is not a form. Happiness is God. Ultimate happiness is Atma. Okay, so right now we become happy by going to Yatra. So much you pay, go there. I had darshan of 1 minute. Mm-hmm. But that fellow, the pujari, pushed me in 1 minute. He didn't even say, allow me to see God for 1 minute. You are paying very heavy price for happiness which is freely available in the form of Atma. That's all this point. So now, you do some actions. Sense organs are seeing object. Okay? I want that happiness. So now, and then mind says, I want that. Then intellect says, go and get it. Then actions happen. Okay? Then you get it. Then an impression is left in the mind. That impression is called vasana. Okay. So the vasana creates one more. I want more. Now who is in charge of your life? You thought all your life your wife is in charge of your life. Okay. Not even wife actually. Your vasanas are in charge of your life. You are driven by the impressions, vasanas. Okay, you say, I am doing this. You have to ask the question, for whom you are doing this? For vasanas, impressions, for objects, you have become slave of objects. Okay. Is it a comfortable situation?
No.
Okay. You can be happy by yourself. Okay. And if you reach the stage, it's called Jivamukti. So that requires a lot of cleanup. The mess is there. Thick mess. Okay, and if you are able to reach that stage when you are alive, it's called Jivanmukti. Then you don't take another life. Otherwise, you take another life, another body for experiencing. It will never end because again it will create some more karma there.
Yeah.
Right? So this is called Punarapi Jananam,
Punarapi
Maranam,
Punarapi
Janani,
Jatare Shayanam,
Iha Samsare,
Bhudusare,
Kripaya
Pare,
Pahi Murare.
Murare.
So what happens is you try to get happiness, right? And whatever, no matter what you do, you can't get happy, fully happy, because it always comes with a package deal, right? If you buy a car, BMW car, annual maintenance cost is 5 lakh rupees. Okay. Every happiness has upfront payment and maintenance cost. And maintenance cost of marriage and children, you know very well.
So
happy.
So the maintenance cost comes, very expensive maintenance cost. But after that also you still want happiness, right? Because somewhere you have hopes, no? Let's say there's a mantra there. I'll chant the mantra. Om ge kamaya ek din om ge kamaya hope of hopes. I'll be happy by something. Then, after many lifetimes, you'll realize it's a hopeless situation. By that time, already you're in deep debt. That's why Shri Krishna says, Bahunam, Janmanam Ante, Nanavan, Mahaprapadyate, Vasudeva, Samamiti, Samahatma, Sadurlabha. So many lifetimes, Krishna says many lifetimes, okay? People, all these people who transcribe this thing, sloka, they say many lifetimes they do upasana for Krishna. Actually, many lifetimes they suffer. To understand Krishna is better. Many lifetimes will go before you realize all these situations are hopeless. Only hope is Atma. So to come back to Atma, Bahunam Janmanam, many lifetimes will take. Then actually gradually, oh, happiness is not outside, happiness is inside. Okay, I will get free. Then you go inside and go to Atma. Okay, Jnanavan Mahaprapadyate, that's called Jnani. He's a wise man. Okay, Prapadyate.
Wise and nice.
There's a mass fooling going on
now. Mass fooling going on. So is this clear now?
Yes.
The vasanas are there. Now these vasanas affect your bodies. Starting from Annamaya Kosha, Pranamaya Kosha, Manomaya Kosha, Vijnanamaya Kosha, they affect your bodies. Right? So, bodies interact with the world. So the vasanas leave impression in the body at various levels. Right? Can you understand?
Yeah.
So how a cup of coffee you drink. So three times you drink. Fourth time your body is programmed now. The moment you see a cup of coffee, saliva. Okay, saliva will start coming.
See smell,
and body will start acting funny. Headache. Guruji, if I don't drink a cup of coffee in the morning, headache. So this vasanas have started imprinting on the body. Okay. Then it imprints the pranamaya kosha also. Okay. The whole headache and itching is starting because pranamaya kosha is going and touching that places. The mind is started crying. I didn't get a cup of coffee. I don't know how do I do my day today. Okay, Buddhi tries to say, don't worry, coffee is not important in life. Mind says, no.
Intellect
says, mind will not listen now. mind is already addicted. So, slowly, you have to make understand Atma is the only reality. Okay?
Are you trying to tell mind or whom are you trying to convince?
Now, who are you? Atma. Depends on who are you.
So, it looks like you are, at least I am operating at a mind level. So when
whoever you think you are, mm-hmm. for the answer. If you are already Atma, you just say, oh, it's very nice. I'm happy already, you'll say. So these teachings will not apply to Atmadhani.
Yeah.
Okay. So to the extent saying that Atmadhani or Brahmadhani, for him, no teaching applies. Yes, already gone beyond it. It's like after you doing PhD, what is the use of those books? Okay. That's why you've seen Dattatreya.
Yes.
Yeah. Dattatreya, near Dattatreya, there are four dogs, you see. Mm. You know what is the four dogs?
Those are cows, no?
No, cows are also there, dogs are there. Mm-hmm. The four dogs are there, four dogs are four Vedas.
Mm-hmm.
Rag Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda, Atharva Veda. For Jnani, Vedas become dogs.
Mm-hmm.
Vedas follow Jnani like dogs. But till we become Jnani, we have to follow Vedas like dogs. We have two dogs.
our quality should be like dogs.
No, we should follow. Not so dogs. Faithful.
Faithful.
Right? So for Jnani, even Vedas, just follow. He doesn't have to follow Vedas. He is beyond Vedas. I mean, he is beyond Vaikuntha, means what else he can say. Right? So, and also, please don't think that, okay, this is all very complicated. No.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? When I say it's so much of this thing, oh, this is all very complex. No, it's not like that. It's all simple. Only thing is we didn't have exposure. Nobody taught us. Okay? Mm-hmm. So once we start applying that, we'll get this also available in everybody's hand. It's that our education is not. In India, a lot of people, this education had this education at young age in earlier days.
Mm-hmm.
So one thing is we didn't get the opportunity. It's not that old. Just because that's why India was called Bharata. The people are enjoying the bliss all the time.
We started seeing outside.
Okay. So don't think it's very complicated. It's simple, but we didn't have education. Any question, Vineet?
No.
So is this clear? Vasanas clear? Now how to become free from this vasanas? So because of these vasanas, our mind is always full.
Mm-hmm.
You can see here?
Yeah, chatter.
Okay. Daily, you get about 60,000 thoughts.
Oh.
And these thoughts are coming from vasanas.
I get only 40,000
thoughts. Oh. How do you know? How do you know?
I calculate.
Every time you calculate, one thought is added. So you say, how you say? You say one thought. One thought.
For one thought, I get, for 1 minute, I get six thoughts.
So six thought is one thought. It is seventh thought. The moment you think of seventh thought, eighth thought will come. The moment you start counting thought, one thought gets added. You understood? See, this is one thought. So the moment I say this one thought already came. Two thoughts only. Oh, two thoughts only. If I think, third thought has come. Right? The moment you start counting thoughts, thoughts will multiply like in this.
I don't know
how
he
calculated.
How?
No, he calculated 1 minute. Because I said, Bhagavan had given us a homework.
To calculate.
Yeah, how many thoughts we get for
So, you have to recheck the calculation. Okay? Because every time you count a thought, one thought gets added.
So you
did you count that?
No.
If you have counted 14,000 thoughts, already 14,000 thoughts get added, which is 28,000 thoughts. Okay, anyway. So thoughts come. But for our day-to-day living, just 50 thoughts to 100 thoughts are sufficient. And then our life will be beautiful.
If you don't go out, I guess.
What, do not go out where?
Work.
Work.
No, no, you work also. Nice. Work also. You don't need thoughts, so much thoughts. Actually, for work-related thoughts are required very few. Every action is not a thought. Once you say, I will do this, that's a thought. Then after that, a lot of activities are.
Right from getting ready and then like getting into your vehicle and then in the road you start seeing.
Yeah, but most of them are routine. Most of them are routine, there's no thought. Actually, when you're driving the car, the whole body is already operating. Thoughts are already going up, what happened, WhatsApp, okay. So now what happened with the thoughts is your brain and nervous system gets filled up, crowded. Mm-hmm. It's like your lap.
These routine thoughts, there could be impressions also from the previous jhanas?
Yes.
Many jhanas also.
Okay. So, you get overloaded with the thoughts. And when the thought is, the computer, like a computer has a virus, so it gets cluttered.
What's clutter?
The clutter means it slows down. Right? If there's a virus, what happens? Then you can't run any program. Overload. Your mobile has a lot of virus, then mobile cannot operate.
The picture you can see, that is clutter.
Yes, yes. See?
The mind.
Mind
is cluttered.
This mind is very clear. Two
minds
are
there. One mind is empty, one mind.
Right? Is it clear? What is it, dog's mind?
He said dog's mind is the best.
Dog's mind is better.
It's just clean, clean is inside.
Right? So can we have this mind like clean mind like this?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So next class, couple of classes, I'm going to tell you how to get that mind. Okay? And please tell me who are all interested. The fees will keep on increasing. This is only marketing. Right? So make the mind uncluttered. How do you do that? Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Okay, there are many techniques I'm going to teach. Okay, meditation is one of the techniques. This video I have to share.
Can you share in the chat screen?
What do I do?
You can play it.
No, no, you're not sharing the screen.
You have to go to the Zoom.
Okay, please understand all these things are not complicated. You have to learn slowly, slowly. It will not happen overnight because you learned a lot of wrong habits. Video.
Share screen. No, there was share screen in the window. Zoom.
Are you okay, sir? There's audio. Light music. So So this is a small Japanese tea ceremony. So she is doing a tea is done as a meditation. Any work can be converted into, you see how she does the tea.
Okay. So, too much of detail, but so what she's doing? So we think the meditation is sitting somewhere and closing our eyes and doing something.
Okay, so any activity when you do, if you are able to,
it's not coming. Yeah. Share.
Keep sharing. Not coming.
Stop sharing.
Okay.
So any activity you can do.
Okay.
When you bring all the five senses and the body into picture, Annamaya Kosha and Manomaya Kosha, Pranamaya Kosha, Vijnanamaya Kosha together,
then
it's a meditation.
That way,
as we call as Karma Yoga.
So anything
you do,
bring all activities,
all five senses together.
Right now,
what's happening? When you do something, eyes are here. Yes, sir. Here, the mind is somewhere.
Okay. Intellect is something else.
So what you have to do,
you are becoming split personality.
Multitasking
is doing one task at repeated, faster rate.
You do this, come back
this like this. But you cannot do two tasks at simultaneously.
So
when you do something, how many person are you?
You are doing cooking,
the mind is talking to somebody. Eyes are seeing something else.
Can you become one single person
when you do your work?
Not necessarily slow down.
Every aspect you have to bring together into one activity.
It's not slowing down.
Slowing down is shown as slow down. So Japanese women,
they do this tea ceremony
once in a while to become meditative.
Meditation?
Through tea, they are doing meditation. Even tea has to be done in the house. Why don't you do it as a meditative activity?
Now, that amount of
focus and concentration, they have to do puja.
So in puja or puja
was designed in such a way that the five senses are fully involved. The flowers, eyes, the ganta, sound,
the agarbati smell, okay,
the lamp, light,
prasadam, mouth.
So all your sense organs and mind should be focused on one activity.
But are we?
No.
Huh? And then you're looking for peace of mind. Do you understand?
The five questions.
When you do any activity,
complete focus should be there.
Vivekananda,
you like that? so what if Vivekananda is like that or somebody else is like that? Ultimately, we have to
bring quality in life. Is it difficult?
For time being, yes.
So I want to remove the concept that meditation means only sitting the eyes, sitting and closing the eyes. Meditation means doing anything can be meditation, including cooking. Only thing is, all sense organs, mind should be on one activity. Then the mind becomes, thoughts should become very less.
Yeah.
Okay. Mind becomes, you start feeling more and more peace in your day-to-day life. This you have to bring consciously into your life. Right? So whenever you bring your attention to the five sense organs, mind becomes peaceful. Okay? For example, right now, let's see. Just become aware, sense organs, body first. They become aware how you are sitting. Become aware your posture, how your leg is, how your hand is. Just straighten your back. Feel the hand on your thighs. So what happens? By doing this simple act, mind becomes silent. Understand? Bring the mind to your body. That's all. Just become attentive to sounds which are coming. There is a silence between the sounds. Become aware of that. Just become aware of your breath. See how silent your mind has become. Very simple actions can make your mind silent. Only thing is, you have to become aware of the sensations and the body. That lady who was making tea, she was enjoying every sensation, the smell, the sound of the towel. So if you are able to do that, every activity of yours you can convert into meditation. So then why do you need a special time for meditation?
Because we're in a hurry.
Even in a hurry you can do, no? It's not, you don't have to do slowly. Even in a hurry, so what we are doing is, our mind is somewhere, the intellect is somewhere,
yeah.
We are a spirit. The meditation is bringing all of them together, becoming aware of the body, becoming aware of the totality. Okay, imagine you are in a room, okay? You are in a room full of snakes. Even if you move a little bit, the snake will bite you. Then how alert you will be? Then your mind will split. Then will you worry? Oh, what is the movie today night in the mud? You can't even, you don't even think, right? And the mind will be totally attention silent. Whereas, now, mind is going here and there, because Prabhuji is not holding a gun at your head. No threat. The attention is drifting. Understand? The meditation means bring the attention to one place. Become aware of your body. Become aware of sensations, surroundings. The mind noise will come down. And who trained your mind? You only. That's why it is noisy. Can you retrain your mind? In small activities. While cooking, while driving a car. You have made your mind unconscious. And that unconscious mind causes a lot of trouble. Mm-hmm. Is your responsibility to bring back the mind to? Can it be done in small actions? See, how are you sitting? Is that the way to sit? Mm-hmm. Slowly. Be aware. See, anything we do with the awareness of the body, that mind becomes comfortable. The mind's responsibility to take care of the body. For example, just become aware of the movement of the hand. Mind becomes peaceful. Mind is restless because the body is somewhere and the mind is somewhere. Right?
Thinking about next.
Have you heard of something called ghost? Have you heard of ghost? What is ghost?
Ghost is not true person.
Have you heard of ghost? Yeah, what is a ghost? What is a ghost?
Without form.
A ghost has a mind but no body.
No body. Yeah.
Right? Does it apply to you? Your body is somewhere, mind is somewhere? Huh? Body is doing something, mind is doing something else. What are you not? Huh? What are you when the body is doing something, mind is doing something else? There is no connection between the body and the mind. Okay. In actually, the ghosts are real. In ghosts in Kannada or in Sanskrit, called Bhuta. Have you heard of that? Bhuta hiddidanta? Nimge hiddide? What has holding you? Your mind is always in Bhuta Kala. Bhuta. Body is in the present. So, Bhuta is past. Body is in the present. And that is called Bhuta in our olden days. You are the biggest Bhuta.
The memories are very strong. What we do?
Memories are not strong. Your mind is drifting. Can you bring the mind and the body to the present moment so that you can become a human being? Being a letter, first human being. Whatever work you are doing, bring the body and mind together. This is one principle, can you follow?
Yes.
Easy?
No.
No. No.
Think. Children don't have that much of.
The children don't have the Bhuta baggage. See, this is the beauty of our life, right? When you're a child, you're a clean slate.
Yeah.
It's innocent. Mm-hmm. Okay, only bliss is there. That's why child is called divine. Right? God.
Yeah.
And slightly become old, go to school. Then the child has future. What will happen to in the future? The child has a future now. What is the future? No, what is the past?
We start asking. What do you want to become?
What do you want to become? You have to think of future. Okay? The child has only future. In the middle age, around 40, 50, so past is also baggage is there, and future doesn't look very good. For the child, looks very, future looks very bright. For middle age, okay, whatever the child was looking very bright and all, so now all those things, okay, the child is very happy, I'll get a very good job, get married, have children, have a car, I'll be happy. So after middle age, all those things are one by one ticked off. Check it out.
Past,
most of the past has gone, hopes have gone. Mm. And extending the future, also future looks to hopeless. So this is called mid-age crisis. Have you heard of this called mid-age crisis?
Yes.
Huh?
Now, the middle-age crisis, people are customers for this. What to do? Why am I?
You can sell it.
So, looking at the past, future also doesn't look very bright. For children, everything bright because they don't have baggage. Okay? And for people become old, then what will happen? They don't have future. The runway is over. Then they will say, Nam kaldali ginnappa. The runway is going to pass because they can't see the future at all. Yo, mundi en agutto gottilla. Nam kaala ketto bidide. Nam kaala. What about our time? They always go back to past. Their past baggage is very big. So, don't have any baggage. Drop all the baggages here. Become free like a child. That's called Adhyatma. Spiritual life. Be peaceful and blissful. Right? So now we'll give 10 minutes break. After that, we'll continue the meditation.
So you are mingling with those who don't.
No, you are unconscious. The problem is you are unconscious. You have to become, you are like a drunkard.
No, it's like a lot of garbage being thrown on us.
No. That's because you are not conscious. Okay? So Katyayani, did you understand? Katyayani, are you there?
She sent a chat message. Yes, I am.
Okay. So
what is the question?
Yeah, who has the question?
Subbu.
Yes, Subbu. Are people able to hear the question? Audio? When Subbu speaks, other people are able to hear? So Subbu, go ahead.
Yeah, as you speak and explain, the mind starts thinking about what you are saying. Is that being distracted from what you are saying, or
no? Just be aware of your body. That's all. In addition, that's all.
Okay.
Okay. Then you are in the present moment because body keeps you in the present moment. Body is the present moment of the mind. You understand?
Yeah.
Hello.
Satya, do you understand? Satya?
So Prabhuji, I'm Charan. So what you're essentially saying is, if the mind is pure and clean and the awareness is kept, then Anandamaya Kosha will come to the top.
Anandamaya Kosha can... Anandamaya is not in top. Always you can tap from the Anandamaya Kosha.
Yes. When everything is silent, the Anandamaya Kosha is...
always open.
Flowing. Yeah.
Right?
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
But to make the Anandamaya Kosha open, body, mind, and intellect, you have to keep in one place. Not okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Just become aware of your body. Immediately, Ananda opens up.
Yes.
Bliss opens up. Because mind has become silent. The way you are standing, just become aware of the body you are standing. Mind becomes silent. The moment mind becomes silent, that's a bliss opens up.
Okay.
Yeah. What happens now? What happens now?
Yes, I want.
So, who else is there? Robin and Padmavati. Who is Padmavati?
No, Satya.
No, there's some Padma. Satya. Okay, Satya. Satya, they are talking. I'm not able to hear you.
Yeah, Prabhuji.
Yeah, are you able to understand what I'm saying?
Yes, I am able to understand.
Okay. See, what mistake you are making in life is you are keeping your mind in the past or future.
Yes.
Mind you have to keep in the present. Okay, how to keep the mind in the present? To become aware of the body, that's all.
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. Because mind is the present moment of the body. Body is the present moment of the mind.
Mm-hmm.
Moment mind comes to present moment, bliss opens up from inside slowly.
Okay.
Right? You are shouting at Sri Charan, no? Shout, but become aware of your body. And Sri Charan, a hint for you. When mother is shouting, become aware of your body. You'll hear blissfully. Mother will also shout blissfully.
Is shouting enough or should I beat it?
Yeah, you can beat also. Then you can aware of the both can become aware of the body. See, the key, please understand, the key formula here is keep a part of the mind on the body. That's it. Simple.
Yeah.
In action. While doing
so whatever action we do, total focus, doing everything with awareness, you to the present moment.
Then also become aware of the body. That's important. Because body is the present moment of the, if you don't become aware of the body, mind will keep drifting.
Yeah.
See, if your attention is fully on my talk, don't worry, because then there will be bliss. If the mind drifts, bring the attention to the body. Okay?
Prabhuji, this is Robin. I have one question.
Yeah.
Like when I'm listening to you, so then the mind comes in and it says, I have to understand what Prabhuji is saying. You know, that causes the jitteriness in mind. You know, I have to understand what Prabhuji is saying. The mind goes on.
No, they say, understand without judgment. Then the mind is focused. Then what will happen? If you understand, listen carefully. Okay. Then what will happen? The understanding is 100%. Now you are trying to say, I have to understand, then the mind is drifting.
Like forcing myself to understand what you are saying, whether it's, am I able to understand properly or not?
Yes.
Okay.
Anyway, what I'm saying is bring consciousness into your day-to-day life. Give attention to the body when the mind is drifting. Is this clear? So that you come to the present moment.
Yes, it's clear.
Can you see, Padmavati, who is Padmavati? Did you understand Padmavati?
Guruji Prasad here, that is my mother.
Oh, okay.
She cannot give feedback.
Okay, fine, no problem. And who else is laying on there?
Geeta.
Geeta, did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, Katyayani, did you understand? Yeah, Katyayani, what you understood? Can you type? Katyayani?
She can talk actually.
Meditating, meditation practice, okay? Yes, is there. Robin, Uncle Robin, and yes, is there. What is this? Teacher, Anna?
Oh, yeah, just that.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, now let us do a meditation practice. Okay. I am actually, today's class, we do a little bit of cleanup of a pranamaya kosha. Okay. Next meditation class, we'll do a little bit of cleanup of chakras. Okay. Some cleanup of pranamaya kosha. Okay. Now this involves a breathing practice. Everybody's listening? Just bring your awareness to the body so that you come to the present moment. Everybody, Sri Charan is there? Are you there online?
Yes, Prabhuji, I'm online.
Subhu Pilupla, you're back?
Yes, Guruji.
Robin?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Satya? Satya is not there. And what about Katyayani? Katyayani, are you there?
Yeah, Prabhuji, I'm here.
Okay, Katyayani?
Katyayani is not here. She logged out.
She logged out?
Yeah.
Okay.
Geeta is there.
Okay.
Can ask Geeta.
Geeta, can you hear? Geeta? So, in this breathing practice, we are charging the pranamaya kosha. Okay. So, when we charge pranamaya kosha, lot of blocks which are there in the pranamaya kosha starts getting released. So, how does the blocks have come? Because of your vasanas, habit patterns. They start getting released at various places in the body. Okay. And how do you do that? You start breathing. Whatever speed you want to do, you do. Slow. But it should go deeper into the abdomen. Okay. And imagine your whole body is like a balloon. Okay. First, give attention to your legs. Let prana gets filled up in the legs, then joints, thigh. So let the body start overflowing with prana. Okay, what will happen is that you start feeling some tingling sensation, some pain, maybe it's pain, tingling sensation, okay, stiffness, headache. None of this maybe. Okay. Or you may start feeling some memories coming up. Some past memories. Okay. Whatever comes up, just continue breathing. Don't stop. There may be stiffness comes up. Okay. There may be sensation. So these are all pranic energy getting released. Okay. Those who are online, I will not be able to monitor you. Okay. This you have to do. There's no harm in this. There's no danger. But as long as you feel comfortable, continue. It's best to continue complete fully. It'll take about 1.5 hours. Are you clear? And you may get some uncomfort. Some sensation. Do you want to do those people who are outside there? You want to do those people online? You want to do or only people do here?
No, Prabhuji, we'll also do.
Okay, if you are feeling very, very uncomfortable, you can stop and relax for some time and come back.
Okay.
But it is best to continue till the session is over. Okay. It will release a lot of your vasanas, lot of your blocks in the pranic body. Is that clear?
Yeah, I was off.
Okay, what I'm saying is, this is a breathing practice.
Okay.
Okay, you breathe at a normal pace or slow pace, but breath has to go to the deep abdomen.
Okay.
Okay. And you keep breathing, whatever pace you want.
Okay.
But no stopping of the breath. You should continuously breathe consciously.
Okay.
And as you do that, take your attention to first leg, the knee, and upper part of the body. Like that, you shift the attention to the raised part of the body. Visualize that your whole body is like a balloon. It's getting filled up with the air.
Okay.
Okay. As you do that, okay, there will be some sensation in the body. Pain, okay, itching, tingling.
Okay.
Or stiffening. It can happen. Many things can happen. Or anything cannot, may not happen also.
Okay.
Just continue with the, what you are doing.
Right.
Okay. Some memories may come also.
Okay.
Okay. And those memories, just note and keep continuing breathing. Don't stop. Is it clear? And memories can be painful. Mm-hmm. Memories can be happy.
When the memories come, you should be shift our attention to the body.
Just keep continuing. Just keep continuing breathing. Okay. Don't stop. And it will take about 1.5 hours. Yeah, there it is. It's called drums. Class 3 drums. Okay, so you have already gone to Atma. I have to bring you back. So Kevala Kumbhaka means Chidavasa has stopped. Chidavasa is not there. So in Chidavasa is not there, you are actually one with Brahman. For a moment. You enjoyed your ticket for a few minutes.
For a few seconds.
Okay. Yeah, few seconds. You can't say because you don't know the time. You will not know the time.
Yeah. My name, then
it's called Kevala Kumbhaka. Kevala Kumbhaka means for a moment. So that time breath stops. When the breath has stopped, Atma has become one with Paramatma. Okay? Sir?
I had a pain in the back. So I was sweating.
Huh. Any uncomfort in the body?
Nothing.
Memories?
No thoughts.
Okay.
I could see some colors.
Your name?
Some dark colors.
What's your name?
Beautiful picturized.
Very good. But how long?
That's only fraction.
Very good.
Twice I got that.
Okay.
Finally, at the end, I developed little
pain. Your name?
I'm Sandeep.
Sandeep. Okay. You only said you are coming from. Okay. So pain was there, yes?
Little.
Okay, how is the mind now?
Mind is very calm.
Cool. Stiffness in the neck, yes.
Okay.
One is through jnana. Okay, another is through prana. So this is pranic way. And jnana is gradual step by step I'm taking you. Okay, that's through dhyana. This is prana. So a combination of these two will help you. Okay, Gayatri?
I didn't force breath when I was in the community. Mm-hmm. On and off, I was going into sleep whenever I listen to your voice.
Okay, any pain in the body? No. Okay. So, this is actually energizing the pranic body. Okay, we have a physical body. Physical body, of course, you do a lot of walking and whatever you do. And physical pranic, annamaya kosha, one thing which you have to bring in is being in the present moment when you work. the pranamaya kosha gets charged. The mind is controlling the body through pranamaya kosha. Right? So what happens when we get a fear in the life? Fear. We are afraid in the. Let us say we are, when we are afraid, what will happen to us?
Stop breathing.
Breathing stops. Okay? So that means the prana stops, gets blocked at certain places. The prana gets blocked in certain places. Prana is controlling the body, but because of fear, you're suddenly blocking. That starts creating blocks in the body. Emotions are there. Body becomes stiff. So they're all creating certain blocks in the prana body. This practice will release that blocks. Okay. And if the body, pranic body is fully charged, then breathing stops. Then jivatma merges with paramatma momentarily. Right? So how many people had an experience of stopping of the breath momentarily? You also had.
Only for a fraction of seconds.
No, that you don't know. Time, you don't know the time.
Yes,
sir. You will not know the time. Suddenly you realize, oh, I have to breath has stopped.
Yeah.
Okay? So when the breath stops, jivatma merges with paramatma momentarily. And that is called it's not a self-realization. It's a momentary experience. Self-realization has happened through dana.
It's like an experience of being something. Small. So you know what's coming.
Okay. And those who are, hands become stiff and all, they're all, that's actually blocks getting released.
What about vibrating hands?
All those things, more energy is tingling.
Lot of energy.
So there's more energy is flowing and clearing all the pranic body. Pranic body gets cleared. Okay. So next class, we are going to clear, we'll work on your chakras. Clear your chakras. Okay. So you need to do this a bit longer time.
Sure.
Okay, a bit longer time.
I can practice it.
You can do that. Around about an hour and a half. Okay, but
can I take a pause between?
No, it has to be continuous, right? But if the fear becomes too much, you need somebody in the presence.
You should come here.
Why do you feel fear?
The fear and all, whatever is blocked, no? They'll come out.
It's a fear.
Yeah. Block. Block.
No.
Huh?
No, not Prabhuji.
No, what happens? Many things we are suppressing, no? The suppression should get. They're like cleaning.
Then why do you feel fear?
The fear was suppressed. It will come out. Okay. There's somebody who goes into dark.
Yeah.
Actually, that we are born in the mother's womb. Uh-huh. When you are in the mother's womb, whatever it is. So you can, you, our mother's womb memories also can come back. Come on. Okay.
Remember that also?
Yeah. You can remember past life also, many times.
How did you know this?
Just like that. Okay. So, yeah. But depending on whatever is required for your body, you come out. Not necessarily everybody has to have the same experience, but whatever is required, you come out. Okay. So, before this class session is over, probably we can do it once more for a slightly longer duration, this 9 months class. Okay.
It was 4 hours.
Wow. Two hours. Okay.
I got 4 hours because you told long duration.
No, today we did it for about
4.5 hours.
1.5 hours.
1.5 hours.
So we'll do 2 hours.
1 hour.
One,
yeah,
one
but
hour.
Audio was
more. 1 hour.
So we'll
do it for 1.5 hours to 1.5 hours. Okay.
Guruji, what is the purpose of background music?
Background music because you people sleep now.
For just to avoid sleeping?
No. What happens is you lose you have to be alert.
And rhythm.
Okay.
Rhythmic.
And bring some rhythm. No, somebody people, they, you feel syncing with music or something like that. Okay. Somebody was singing. Supu, you are there?
Yes, Guruji.
So, what is your experience? What happened?
Yes, for a while the breathing stopped for me. I felt refreshed. I had some pain in my left arm that has gone away.
Pain in the left arm has gone, okay. Any memories, any thoughts?
No memories, no thoughts.
Okay. Okay, good. Any questions are there? So everybody's comfortable? Mind is peaceful for everybody?
Yes.
Okay, let us close for the day. So next class, I'll take chakras.
You have to practice this,
right? This you can practice.
Okay. How long?
This you can practice. It's like, say, there is whatever is it? Your whole body gets energized. Okay. But don't overdo it. Okay, what you can do is probably every day if you are doing it, you do it for half an hour. But once in a week or so, do it for longer.
Guruji, they're teaching now Sudarshan Kriya. So it is the same practice.
Sudarshan Kriya is called Bhastrika.
No, uske baad, at the end of this Bhastrika, they take up this.
Well, this is what?
Sudarshan Kriya, they call it.
This is Sudarshan
Kriya. After the spider meeting.
Next class. I came to know that it's called Sudarshan Kriya now. I didn't know. I have not grown up in that.
He's asking how would Prabhuji know? They have designed the course like Ravi Shankar.
ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
सदगुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
सदगुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
मेरा अंतर तिमिर मिटाओ सदगुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
हे योगेश्वर
हे ज्ञानेश्वर
हे परमेश्वर
हे सर्वेश्वर
निज कृपा बरसाओ
सदगुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ मेरा अंतर
तिमिर मिटाओ
सदगुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
सदगुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
सदगुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
सदगुरु ज्योत से जगाओ
मेरा अंतर
तिमिर मिटाओ
सदगुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
सदगुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
हम बालक
तेरे द्वार पे आए
सदगुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
सतगुरु ज्योत से ज्योत
मेरा
अंतर
तिमिर मिटाओ
तिमिर मिटाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ शीश झुकाए
करे तेरी आरती प्रेम सुधा बरसाओ
प्रेम सुधा बरसाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
मेरा
अंतर
तिमिर मिठाओ
तिमिर मिठाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ अंतर में युग
युग
से सोई
चिति शक्ति को जगाओ
चिति शक्ति को जगाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ मेरा अंतर
तिमिर मिटाओ
तिमिर मिटाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ सच्ची ज्योत
जगे
हृदय में
सोहम नाद जगाओ सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
मेरा अंतर
तिमिर मिठाओ सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
जीवन आत्मा
आनंद अविनाशी
चरण न शरण लगाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
मेरा अंतर
तिमिर मिठाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
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 मेरा अंतर
तिमिर मिठाओ
सद्गुरु ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ
ज्योत से ज्योत जगाओ मनोबुद्धि
अहंकार
चित्ताणि नाहम
I am not the mind
not the intelligence
or ego
Naja shrotra jivve Naja prana netre
I am not the five organs
of knowledge Naja vyoma
Bhumirna
Tejona Vayuhu.
I am not five
elements. Chidanandarupaha.
Shivoham.
Shivoham. I am pure consciousness.
Shivasvarupi.
na cha prana sanno na vai pancha vayuhu. I'm not five pranas or five vital airs. Nava sapta dhatuhu nava pancha koshaha. I am not
five
layers of the body.
Today
we saw the five layers. Okay, the idea is to understand I'm not the five layers. So
but anandi kosha is I am.
You are that also. You are not. You are atma. You want bliss, but that anandamaya kosha bliss also is coming from atma only. It's coming very close to atma, that's why he's getting it. Na vak pani padam na cha upastha payuhu. I am not five organs of action. Chidananda rupah
shivoham.
I'm pure consciousness. Shivasurupi. Name desha ragau name lobha mohau raga dvesha. Are not for me. Mado naiva me naiva matsarya bhavaha ego haughtiness
jealousy
are not for me. Na dharmo
na
cha artho
na
kamo na mokshaha dharma artha kama moksha are not for me. Chidananda rupah
shivoham.
I'm pure consciousness. Shivasurupi. Na punyam
na
papam
na saukyam
na dukkham. Good merit
and sin.
Happiness
and
unhappiness
are not for me.
So this all actually is a part of your mind. Okay, you are not the mind at all. You are the atma. Whatever is happening to the mind is not there for you at all. Right now you are confusing yourself with the mind. Aham
bhojanam naiva
bhojyam
na
bhokta.
I am not the experiencer.
Or experienced. So we say, I was a very happy person. I was a very sad person. I am suffering. All these are not for you, really. Only atma, ananda, bliss is your nature. Chidananda rupaha
shivoham.
I am pure consciousness.
Shivasurupi.
Na mrityur na shanka
name
jati vedaha.
No birth.
No death. Pita
naiva
me naiva mata na janmaha. I have no father. Or no mother.
No.
So this father and mother are for the body. Okay. Really, I am consciousness, Chaitanyam. Only Shiva is the father. Na bandur,
na bandur,
na mitram,
na mitram,
guru naiva shishyam. Neither guru nor shishya. I have. Chidananda rupah
shivoham.
I am pure consciousness.
Shivasurupi.
Aham nirvikalpo
nirakara
rupo. I am thoughtless and formless. See, well, those who had experience of brief stopping of the breath, that's atmasurupa. That's your real nature. Okay, everything else is a mind creating. Your real nature is that brief time when you didn't have thought. Or you can even think that in deep sleep what you have is your real nature. Your real nature is deep sleep. Okay, then thoughts come and go. So, but what happens, we confuse ourselves with the thoughts. The whole idea is we should be like in deep sleep in the waking state.
Yeah.
Very peaceful, but interact. Thoughts should reduce drastically.
Experience deep sleep. It's like when you're sleeping, you won't be aware of that part of
No, that's why you are sleeping, no?
But you
see,
don't know.
You don't even know when you actually
okay, sleep. Let me ask you. Did you have a good sleep yesterday? You don't know?
What is
yeah. Who had a good sleep? I had a good sleep in class of you?
No.
Huh?
But I don't know what kind of
Wait. My question is answer. Did you have a good sleep or not?
Yeah.
It is my experience you are saying or your experience?
My experience.
So that means you have an experience of good sleep. So, what it means? You were aware of the experience.
Yeah.
If you didn't have experience, how did you know you had a good sleep?
Yeah.
So, the good sleep is experience, a special experience where you are not experiencing anything, you are enjoying that experience. Right?
Mm.
You had a good sleep and you say, I enjoy good sleep. That means you are coming out of good sleep. You are missing the experience.
Yeah.
Sorry. So, good sleep is a very special experience where you are enjoying your real nature. Understand? So that is actually Atma. So now what we are trying to do is in the waking state also, not going to this thing. Waking state also our mind makes so silent that one side we are like a deep sleep and other side we are fully active. That you have to achieve. Right?
Mm.
That is thoughts have to come down drastically, like sleep. But you are fully active like waking state. That's what it's called Jivan Mukti finally.
Or drastically?
No,
slow.
Reduce.
Big difference.
Nacha Sangam Sangatam Naiva Mukti Nameyaha. I have no bondage,
no liberation.
Okay, so this is actually called what I want Mukti and all is all created by the mind. Illusions. Not real. Atma is always free. As a child, you are Atma only. But as the mind started coming up from the society, you have started confusion. Really, Atma is always key. So that you have to realize now, gradually. Chidananda Rupaha, Shivoham, Shivoham, I am pure consciousness, Shivasarupi. Asatoma, Sadgamaya, Tamasoma, Jyotirgamaya, Mrityorma, Amritamgamaya, Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi, Lokaha Samasta, Sukhino Bhavantu, Lokaha Samasta, Sukhino Bhavantu, Lokaha Samasta, Sukhino Bhavantu, Harihi Om, Shri Gurubhyo Namaha, Harihi Om. So I have told you some different practices. Breath observation, chanting, mantra japa, akara ukara. And each of them has a specific purpose. Akara ukara, it changes your energy system in the body. Okay, chanting changes your inner purification. So this will bring make the mind peaceful. So practice this. As you practice, you'll become more and more. Then gradually, or in waking state also, you'll be fully peaceful. That's our idea. Okay. So, and also you'll gradually realize that I'm Shivaswarupi only in the waking state. Just like I'm body, I'm Shivaswarupi. Right? That recognition has to happen. There's a purpose. So this breathing practice which I have told you practice it half an hour, 25 minutes, 30 minutes, so that you feel peaceful. Chanting, you do it. So then it will purify you. Is it simple? Any complexities there?
No.
Time is there available for you?
Yes. Yeah.
You have enough time for everything in the world, okay? Give some time for this also. Right.